good to be here with everyone today for this roundtable on the cultures and the cultural context for some of the conflicts we're reading about or hearing about in the news today, and to have the opportunity to talk with each of you and then as a group. As Kristen mentioned, I'm Karis Thompson. I work with Intercultural Affairs at Concordia College, and I'm very excited to be a part of this conversation today. And I'm wondering if we could begin by just a brief introduction of each of you, your name, and the country that you originated from. Beginning with you.
My name is Hassan Ghazi. I've been here quite a few years. I'm a retired professor of engineering. I've been in the States, like I said, 55 years, something like that. So I'm pretty accustomed to everything that's going on.
Wonderful to meet you.
My name is Leticia Mizero, and I'm originally from Burundi. I've been in this community since the fall of 1998, and I'm currently working as a family involvement coordinator and cultural liaison for Sendka Head Start.
My name is Fauzia Adi. I'm from Somalia. I am here in this community since 1997, December. And I love to be here. I'm raising my children here.
My name is Prashant Singh. I'm from Nepal and came here in 2005, August. Mm. I'm currently studying at NDSU architecture.
Well, my first question is related to U.S. perspectives about international affairs and international news. Often we might hear a headline might contain some information about a certain event. Maybe it will be about a military conflict or a political interaction, an election, or maybe some sort of tragedy. But often our assessment or appreciation of what's happening within the world is limited to what might happen within a single event that is, quote, newsworthy. And there's so much happening in the world, and yet what we might pay attention to is such a limited percentage of all of the major events that are unfolding at any given moment. So we might hear about Syria, and it might be a week of reporting, and then we move on to the next crisis or the next situation or circumstance. So I'm wondering if we could think of this conversation as an opportunity for each of you to offer more by way of context and to discuss the causes and some of the insights around a conflict, maybe the conflict that caused you to come to America or what is currently unfolding in your country that we might not learn via the media here in the U.S.
Well, the media here is a little bit biased, and it's a little bit, you know, given to us in after a certain filter. Usually the filter is another American who actually gets really only part of the story, or sometimes most of the time gets the wrong story, and that gets to the entire United States as the truth, and it's not the truth most of the time, which is the main problem, I think. One time they actually wrote that Nepali people worshipped frogs, and I read it in an article, and I'm going, I've never heard of this in my life, but it was written, and it was perceived as the truth. Little things like that. Usually the reporters just grab for what is the most shiniest piece of information that they can find. Mm-hmm. And it's usually the rarest and least occurring one. Mm-hmm. And it's usually the wrong one.
To build on what Prashanta just shared, we don't hear much about Burundi. We don't hear much about what happened in Burundi. And as much as we hear what's going on right now in the Middle East or in some countries where, you know, on a daily basis we hear about Afghanistan, we hear about Iraq, we hear about the devastation in Japan, and not even a tenth of what we hear in some parts of the world has been talked about, you know, with the Central African, Central Africa in general. And And I know that like the genocide that was that happened in Rwanda, which is like north of Burundi, and mm-hmm. Rwanda and Burundi have the same history in terms of conflict, and we have the same composition of population. The conflicts have always revolved around those two tribes, and depending on how it's portrayed as an ethnic problem or political problem, but it has always been around the Hutus and Tutsis. But both countries have had like very comparable atrocities, mm-hmm. and the extent of casualties or killings, you know, are very comparable. But we really didn't hear much about Rwanda until the movie Hotel Rwanda was made a couple years mm-hmm. ago. And but when the horrors were happening, and when maybe the countries were needed to, you know, the word to get out and the support maybe from the international community to show up, I mean, it was not there. So we, at least in Burundi, we, or some of the people that I talked to, we have an impression that United States will, you know, like in the other countries, other developed countries will only intervene and, you know, publicize places or conflicts or events that where they have interest. So, which is like, you know, understandable, but as a human being, as a victim of a place that has not been known at all, pretty much, or publicized at all, you know, it's
it's a mixture.
Yes.
It's a mixture.
Yes.
Interest in the locality of the place, mm-hmm. what's involved politically, plus mm-hmm. what's happening actually. So
that's true.
You have to, you know, it's a collaboration of reasons that we interfere in one mm-hmm. location, we don't interfere in another location. Mm-hmm. But when one big event takes place in that location, then it becomes public suddenly, and you hear about it, what happened in Burundi and Rwanda and so mm-hmm. on. Of course, it's unfortunate, but it takes a little time for it to develop and slowly come out into the open. On the other hand, you have situations like in Libya right now, mm-hmm. bang, it's right up front mm-hmm. page right away.
That's true.
Because of oil, yes. plus politics of the situation, mm-hmm. and lots of other things.
You know. And Gaddafi is such a recognizable
correct,
leader.
Correct, correct. Mm-hmm. But I mean, on the other hand, you have to, you know, you have to give credit that mm-hmm. you do hear about it in
that's
the States,
true.
While you never hear about it forever
that's
in some
true.
Other places. Mm-hmm. So.
How does the coverage of what's unfolding in Syria currently compare with what you're hearing from your wife's sister?
She cannot tell. She doesn't know. Well, she cannot talk about what's happening in Syria. You don't talk politics when you're in Syria. As long as you stay away from politics, you're okay. I mean, people think that Syria is a terrible place, it's dangerous and all this and that. It's dangerous if you stick your neck out into the politics of the situation. Mm-hmm. If you stay out of politics, mm-hmm. you're okay. I visited there last year. I was there last summer. It's no problem.
Okay.
No problem.
And I think it's a case like in many other countries where maybe democracy is not like what it is here, where, you know, like maybe the freedom of expression,
sure.
I think, to
of
some
course,
extent.
Of course.
Because I know that if you go back to Burundi today, you know, your safety is also linked to how much involved your involvement you want to, how much involved you are in politics. That's one maybe aspect where most people don't feel like I can do or say or write anything I want.
Sure,
you know,
like the sister of my wife. I mean, mm-hmm. she talks to her on Skype. On. Mm-hmm. She asks questions. Of course, she knows that she cannot say mm-hmm. things. I mean, she has to worry. Her sister has to worry about her situation back there. She may say something that maybe the political situation doesn't allow her to mm-hmm. say. It's a bad thing, and so she stays out of it. Like I said, I mean, life goes on very nicely for whoever wants to live there. But just don't interfere. I mean, don't try to take over the government. Don't try to say, you know, it's a bad government or it's a whatever it is, just manage to live your life within the confines of whatever is allowed. Mm-hmm. Boundaries are fixed. They're very well known. You stay within those boundaries, it's okay. Mm-hmm. If you want to get ahead a little bit in the politics of the situation, then you're taking, you know, it's a chance.
When I say I'm from Somalia, people say, oh, is that where the pirates are from? You know, that's the first thing media talks about the Somalian pirates and also the situation that's happening. But the conflict that Somalia happened 20 years ago, it's linked to our history of as a country who used to be under colony, and Somalia was divided in five different states, the land, the Somalian was divided in five different countries. Itself, the small country was divided. We have Northern Somalian, we have the Southern Somalian, Somali Ethiopian, Somali Kenyan, and also Djibouti was created after all. That's what happened to us after the colony. Colony divide Somalia very well. And that's where the whole conflict of interest started from the beginning. Tribalism and division, and that's what caused, you know, when I listen or read about our history in Somalian history, you know, we always had problem. It's, you know, when we had peace in all the 21 years when Siad Barre was there, but always Somalian, that small country always was in trouble. And that's not what media talks about. The way Somalia was divided caused us where we are right now. And sometimes, you know, African in general are betrayed differently in TV and the life of Africans. My children, they were all born here, but when I say we will go back to Africa to visit, or, you know, they just say, no, mommy, no, mommy. And they're 12 years old, 9 years, they are young.
Well, of course, they have no attachment. Yeah. It's not the same as you or somebody who grew up.
And then they go by their media, what their media told them, you know, about Africa, people die, there is no food, there is no jobs, there is nothing. And I'm surprised when my children tell me we don't want to go to Africa. And I tell them, no, that's not the truth. That's where I was raised. There was these fruits we used to eat. This is what I used to do, what the schools that I went. So media kind of portrays Africa in general different.
And maybe an exclusive focus on the crisis or the conflict and less attention to everything else that's happening or day-to-day realities.
Mm-hmm.